What's up guys, this is Hal Hart, back with another video. Before we get started, make sure that you like and subscribe if you enjoy this content and you want more videos. In this video, I want to talk about CRS. And you may be saying, what is CRS? Well, here we go. CRS stands for Coordinate Reference System. It may also be known as the Spatial Reference System, or the SRS. It is a place or a frame or space where objects can be located by intersecting planes. Now, there are two main types of CRS. That is the geographic and the projected. The geographic is 3D. It is more than just flat. It is a pop-out image of an object. It uses latitudes and longitudes to represent those features. 3D images or 3D maps are measured in degrees or in timestamps or time signatures. The projected is flat. It is two-dimensional, 2D. And it uses the X and the Y axis. Now that I got that off my chest, I want to show you how to manipulate CRS in QGIS. There are several ways. So let's get into it. I brought in two layers here. Okay. And the first layer that I brought in was this state shapefile. So when I click on this layer and I go into the information tab, I get two very key pieces of information. I get the CRS right here and I get the unit. How is this layer being measured? Now, let's go ahead and exit that and let's go check out the other shapefile. In this shapefile, I see that I have my CRS and it's being measured in meters. Okay, now we're here. Let's say that I want to create a point layer. I'll call it PL1, one, and I'll put the point here. Okay, so this is the first section that you could possibly change your CRS. Now, they have multiple options here, default options. And if you have multiple layers here, they'll go ahead and input those CRSs into this list. Now, let's say that what you're looking for is not here. Well, you'll be able to use this little select button, or not select button, but just button, to get to your coordinate reference system selector. So since I already have this set as a default, I want to use the STCO. And we know it was that Mississippi TM3814. So you can either double click this or hit OK to apply this to your new point layer. And what this means is that you're changing what the point layer would be by default. You're changing that. So I'm going to go ahead and double click and it changes here to the Mississippi TM and I'll press OK. Okay. And what we'll see here is if I double click my point layer and I see that my CRS and my units are the same as my STCO. Let's say if I wanted to create another point layer two, and let's say I forgot. I left this as default and I forgot to do my change. Well, what I can do here, there are two options. I could go to my STCO, double click it, and I could copy my CRS. Copy that, and I can go to my point layer two, which should be, let's check the properties, it should be default. And I could say, okay, well, let me right click this. And I'll come down to where it says set CRS. Set layer CRS. Boom. And we already copied what we needed. Of course, what we needed is already here, but this is because it's recently used. If it wasn't recently used, you would just paste your what you have, and we're looking and it's blank. Well, this is because there's too much information here. Let's back off some of this information and see if we can narrow down. You just keep on deleting until it pops in. Bam. Okay, so it's the same thing. You just double click or press OK and it will be applied to your point layer. Bang. We'll go check those properties. And there it is. New meters. And this can be done with not just point layers. It can be done with buffers, point line, poly, multi-line, multi-poly, any kind of shapes, any kind of buffers that you are going to put in, as long as it is not a shape file, a new shape file, trying to force a new CRS on the default, which would be this state, default layer. Another thing, if you want to know about the default layer, you go to settings, options, and in here there's a tab called the CRS, and you can actually set a default CRS that will always be used when you come into your QGIS, or you can have this setting that says the first layer added, that will be our CRS. And then for new layers, you can set, like say if you have a new point layer or a new whatever layer, you can set those here. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.